Imagine a world in which your medical care is tailored just for you. Using information about your environment, history, and genetics, your doctors could customize your healthcare. For example, if your genetic information showed an increased risk for certain cancers, they could recommend a specific screening plan. If your genetic information showed you wouldn't respond well to a medication, they could prescribe you a different one. Doctors could better use genetic and other information about their patients to give the right people the right treatments at the right time. Every day, we get closer to this goal, but we still have more to learn. Why? For starters, analyzing a person's genetic information is not as simple as you might think. Each person's genetic code, while overall very similar to everyone else's, has thousands of changes from person to person. These are part of what makes us unique. Some genetic changes may have no noticeable effect, or may contribute to minor differences between us, like eye color or blood type. Others may have significant impact on our health or development, such as the changes that cause conditions like cystic fibrosis or sickle cell anemia. Genetic testing laboratories try to categorize each change they find into groups based on what information is available about the change. If the lab finds compelling evidence that the change has no significant effect on health, they categorize it as benign. Likewise, if they are able to find significant evidence that the change causes a particular disease, they categorize it as pathogenic. However, this distinction is not always clear. For many genetic changes, there is simply not enough available information to put it into either category. When this happens, the change is categorized as uncertain. The more information available about genetic changes, the more laboratories can move changes from uncertain into the pathogenic or benign categories, making it easier for doctors to use that information to guide their patients' care. One of the best ways to help classify these changes and to gather more information is for laboratories, patients, and doctors to share their findings. When we pool our information together, we are better able to learn from each other's experiences. Many genetic testing laboratories currently share a summary of the information they have about specific genetic changes with other doctors, laboratories, and researchers. This summary information is very generalized and does not contain any protected health information, such as names, dates of birth, medical record numbers, or doctors' names. This summary is created by merging information from many tests together and typically includes the total number of times the lab has seen a particular genetic change, a group description of the people they have seen it in, and whether or not they think it's related to a specific genetic condition and why. For example, a laboratory has seen a certain genetic change in 5 people they have tested. The change was found in 4 females and 1 male. Of those 5 individuals, 2 were Caucasian, 1 was African American, and the other 2 individuals' race or ethnicity was not specified. 4 of the 5 individuals had breast cancer, 1 had ovarian cancer, and 1 had developmental delay, which is not a typical symptom for people with changes in this gene. As you can see, we cannot tell which of the 5 people had each of these health conditions. This is helpful, but it would be even more helpful if the doctors and researchers knew more about each individual, not just the group as a whole. For example, which people had breast cancer? Which had ovarian cancer? Did anyone have both? Which one had the developmental delay? Does anyone have other unique genetic changes? Could those be causing their reported health issues? The Clinical Genome Resource, or ClinGen, is working with your registry to ask your permission to share more specific individual information about any genetic changes you may have to help us better understand these questions. ClinGen is a National Institutes of Health-funded project dedicated to creating a resource that defines how genes and genetic changes impact health. This effort relies on sharing of this detailed data. Choosing yes on the ClinGen Data Sharing Program consent allows the ClinGen team to access your genetic and health information within the registry and share this to improve patient care and advance genetic knowledge. Information shared could include general information about you, such as your age, sex, race, and ethnicity, your health history, your test results, and the reason your test was ordered. Data sharing would not include your personal identifying information. If you choose yes, the ClinGen team may contact you to ask you to upload a copy of your genetic test results to your registry account. And your registry coordinator may contact you to ask you to complete additional optional health surveys. ClinGen also gives you an option to receive potential updates to your genetic test results if we learn that the genetic change found through your testing may now be categorized differently than how it is listed on your report. If you choose no on the ClinGen Data Sharing Program consent, ClinGen will not access your information and your individual information will not be shared. If you choose to participate, ClinGen may share individual information with two types of databases, and there are benefits to having information available in both types. An open access database is publicly available to anyone with internet access and does not require a password. These databases are most often used by professionals involved in patient care that need quick and easy access to the information they are looking for. This is particularly important when a doctor is with a patient, or when a laboratory is working on a case for which their interpretation is needed in a short time frame. Controlled access databases are not open to the general public. These types of databases are only available to approved users who request access from an oversight committee to use it for a specific purpose. These databases are most often used by researchers with a specific project already in mind. These projects are often not time sensitive, so it is easier to go through the full review and approval process. Because access is controlled, ClinGen may share more detailed information, such as a complete list of all the changes found during genetic testing. ClinGen also will have access to this de-identified genetic and health data for ClinGen-related activities, which may be displayed on the ClinGen website. Choosing yes on the ClinGen Data Sharing Program consent form allows your individual information to be shared with ClinGen and in both types of databases. If you're uncomfortable with this, you should consider choosing no. When making your decision about participating in the ClinGen Data Sharing Program, it's important to consider the potential risks and benefits. A potential risk is the chance you could be identified from the information shared and that it could be used to discriminate against you in some way. Your privacy is very important to us, and because of this, we take measures to safeguard your personal information. Before anything is shared, your name, date of birth, and address are removed, and a unique numerical code is assigned. This code is then securely stored, which greatly reduces risks to your privacy, but does not eliminate them completely. Since many genetic changes are rare, it is possible that you could be one of only a few people in the world, or the only person, with a particular genetic change. It is important to realize that the more widely you share your genetic and health information, the greater the possibility that you could be identified based on this alone. Keep in mind that simply telling people that you had genetic testing, even telling them the gene in which your change is located, is often not enough information to identify you. We believe the risk of being identified through sharing your individual information is low, but it is not impossible, particularly if you have directly shared this information with others. If, for any reason, someone were to identify you, a federal law called the Genetic Information Non-Discrimination Act has been put in place to protect you against discrimination by health insurance companies, group health plans, and most, but not all, employers. Currently, no federal legislation is in place to cover discrimination by life, disability, or long-term insurance carriers. Laws in each individual state dedicated to genetic information, privacy, and non-discrimination vary. To learn more about the laws in your state, visit clinicalgenome.org/laws. Though you might not see any immediate personal benefits, your participation may help you, members of your family, and others with the same genetic change or disease in the future by improving understanding of genetics and health. You also could potentially connect with other researchers or clinicians interested in your particular gene or genetic change, and you have the option to receive updates about your genetic test results. We hope you have found this video helpful and informative as you make your decision. Please contact our team if you have any additional questions at datashare@clinicalgenome.org or 570-214-1721, toll-free 855-322-7683.